Welcome to your tour of the RIT campus.
My name is Morgan Conley, and I am a first-year interpreting student from Boston.
The many labs, classrooms, galleries, and other facilities you're about to see are part of why we're always onto something amazing here at RIT. Of course, this is just a glimpse of what RIT has to offer, so we hope after this tour you'll arrange for an in-person visit to see even more.
As we begin, our first stop is the Magic Spell Studios. Here, 52,000 square feet are devoted to digital media production, rivaling studios in New York City and Hollywood. Included within Magic is the Wegmans Theater, a 180-seat capacity theater with Dolby Atmos sound and 4K laser projection. The Soundstage, a 7,000 square foot area, provides resources and space to both student and professional filmmakers. Magic also boasts 2D and 3D animation classrooms, an AR-VR lab, stop motion facilities, and demo lounge. Next up, Gannett Hall houses the Schools of Film and Animation and Photographic Arts and Sciences in the College of Art and Design. The photo school boasts one of the most impressive photographic facilities in education, made even more impressive because of an extensive $3.5 million renovation. If that weren't enough great news, the photo school is also proud to recognize the latest RIT alums to win a Pulitzer Prize for Journalism Excellence, Evan Vucci from the class of 2000. His win makes that 11 photography alumni who have won a combined 15 Pulitzer Prizes. The College of Art and Design is also home to the School of Film and Animation. Our graduates are working at major studios and animation companies and have received screen credits on films like Frozen, the Marvel movie franchise, and Pirates of the Caribbean. We are now leaving Gannett Hall and moving to Booth Hall, home to the School of Art and the School of Design. The Bevere Art Gallery and the University Gallery feature the work of students, faculty, alumni, and esteemed national and international artists and designers. If you're on campus in the future, be sure to put these galleries on your list of places to visit. The School of Design is ranked among the best, with Business Week naming it one of the top 10 design schools in the country. Students work with award-winning faculty and have access to state-of-the-art laboratories and computer facilities, as well as the Cary Graphic Arts Collection and the entire archive of renowned designers Massimo and Leila Vignelli, housed in RIT's Vignelli Center for Design Studies. The Vignelli graphic and product designs are icons of international design, and two prime examples include American Airlines and the New York City subway system maps. As we leave Booth Hall, we are passing through the Unity Quad, named after the sculpture you see in the center. The sculpture is composed of three individual sections. The three sections represent the unity of science, technology, and art at RIT. Take note of the Chester F. Carlson Center for Imaging Science, the only institution to offer bachelor's, master's, and doctoral degrees in imaging science in the nation. Current research in the center includes projects sponsored by NASA, the U.S. Department of Defense, and the National Science Foundation, among others. That's the Center for Bioscience Education and Technology, or CBIT, as it's commonly referred to. The College of Health Sciences and Technology, housed in CBIT, highlights RIT's commitment to healthcare by putting its medically related programs in one academic college. One of the unique features in the building is the cadaver lab, which gives students a huge advantage when applying to medical, physician assistant, dental, or physical therapy school. Most undergraduates at other universities do not get to have this experience. Also in this building is a physician assistant training lab and a large diagnostic medical sonography scanning simulator lab. The Wegman School of Health and Nutrition is located in the 45,000 square foot Clinical Health Sciences Center that opened in the fall of 2015. This center features state-of-the-art clinical health simulation facilities and research facilities for behavioral science. Our next stop is the James E. Gleason Hall, home to the Kate Gleason College of Engineering. Gleason Hall is also home to many of our performance teams, including Formula SAE and Hot Wheels Formula SAE Electric Vehicle Team, the first all-female team to compete in the Formula Hybrid competition. These performance teams and others do much of their work in the Earl W. Brinkman Machine Tools and Manufacturing Lab. Inside this lab are computer numerical controlled machines and additive machining tools, such as 3D printers and rapid prototypers, and even a 3D liquid metal printer. Here you can see the Center of Microelectronic Engineering and the home of the nation's first undergraduate program in microelectronic engineering, where students' coursework focuses on the design and manufacture of semiconductors or silicon computer chips in the Semiconductor and Microsystems Fabrication Laboratory. From here, we're entering the Engineering Technology Hall, home to the College of Engineering Technology. Our Women in Technology program calls this facility home as they work to build community for women in tech programs through professional development opportunities, community service, and social events. Louise Slaughter Hall houses labs for majors in industrial and manufacturing engineering. manufacturing, engineering, technology, and packaging science. It also houses the Center for Integrated Manufacturing Studies. This facility is also the site for military testing and fuel cell research, as well as many federal and state grant-funded projects. From here, we move on to the Golisano Institute for Sustainability that is housed in the platinum level, LEED certified building, designed to demonstrate sustainable building technologies and energy systems. Inside this spectacular facility, multidisciplinary staff are working on sustainable production, sustainable energy, and ecologically friendly information technology systems. GIS has received several national awards for its research and outreach efforts. Before we get to the Golisano College of Computing and Information Sciences, we will be walking by the future site for the Performing Arts Complex. Phase one of this project includes a state-of-the-art music performance theater with seating for 750, costume and scene shops, rehearsal space, as well as flexible space for a variety of uses. RIT also seeks to add a 1,500-seat orchestra hall for larger audiences as a second phase to this project. We're now on to the Golisano College of Computing and Information Sciences in Golisano Hall. It is our largest college with an enrollment now almost 3,800 students, offering 16 degree programs at the bachelor's, master's, and doctorate level. We are one of the most comprehensive computing colleges in the US. On the second floor is the Air Gap Lab, a self-contained lab used to teach students how to protect an organization's data and infrastructure from hackers, viruses, and other forms of attacks. Since it is isolated from the rest of the campus's infrastructure, students can experiment with all types of attacks without endangering any other computers on campus. This also allows us to host attack and defend competitions throughout the year. Across the atrium is the Gaming Lab. RIT's game design and development program is consistently ranked top 10 in the nation. The third floor includes a graphics lab where students use a motion capture suit to create virtual theater performances. They also have artificial intelligence labs where they are now researching new intelligent systems. Many clubs and student organizations are housed in the Golisano College, including the Society of Software Engineers, Esports, Game Developers Club, Code RIT, and Women in Computing. The Global Cybersecurity Institute is expanding RIT's capabilities in three areas of cybersecurity: education, training, and research. Here, our students and researchers are working to build secure systems, software, devices, and technologies of the future. The facility is home to the Cyber Range, a state-of-the-art computer lab where students can simulate large-scale, realistic network attacks so they can prepare themselves for the next real attack. Now we're moving to the Student Innovation Hall, home to the Simone Center for Student Innovation and Entrepreneurship. The Innovation Center is a flexible work and display center where innovators and multidisciplinary teams can come together and develop and advance their ideas. For the rest of the tour, I'm going to turn you over to Keith. Hope to see you again soon.
Thanks, Morgan. I'm Keith Gonzalez, a first-year game design and development student from Brooklyn. Welcome to Global Village, an internationally inspired, LEED-certified sustainable residential community and commercial complex located on the south side of campus. The retail spaces include four restaurants, two convenience stores, a post office, a bank, a unisex hair salon, and Shop One, an RIT-made art, craft, and design shop. From Global Village, we're walking east to Max Lowenthal Hall, home of the Saunders College of Business. Currently, the facility boasts a number of smart classrooms, Bloomberg terminals, and the latest analytics and data visualization software, as well as the Sklarsky Analytics Center.
In terms of ranking and recognition, Saunders College is consistently among the top nationally for undergraduate programs in the U.S. News and World Report rankings. Not to mention, one of the largest colleges across RIT's global campuses in China, Dubai, and Croatia.
A $19-plus million expansion will double the size of Lowenthal Hall by 2024. Plans for the 35,000 square foot addition incorporate applied learning and collaboration elements, including additional classrooms, applied research laboratories, event space, a large auditorium, and student team rooms. As we leave Lowenthal Hall and Saunders College, we are approaching the Jean Polisseni Center, the home of the men and women's Division I hockey teams. The Polisseni Center is a great place to be on Friday and Saturday nights, taking in the action and joining fellow Tigers, cheering on our men's and women's hockey teams. Now is off to the Thomas Gosnell Hall, home to the College of Science. Notable in this hall is the Bruce and Nora Jane's atrium. The granite floor is etched with images to represent milestones in science. In addition, there are 11 research centers and labs at the college, including labs specific to genetic engineering, aquatic ecology, and quantum optics. Exiting out of the front of Gosnell Hall, we are looking on the quarter mile. Looking east, we see the Mobius Quad, otherwise known as the Infinity Quad, named as such based on the Mobius Strip sculpture. While the Mobius Strip marks the beginning or the end of the quarter mile on the academic side of campus, the sundial marks the other beginning or end of the quarter mile on the resident side of campus.
The next stop on our tour is the Wallace Center.
The first floor of the Wallace is home to Java Wallies, so we can fuel up for those late night study sessions. Not that long ago, the first floor of the library was renovated, as the books were moved off the first floor to allow for more student collaboration and study spaces.
More recently, we have seen the addition of the Student Hall for Exploration and Development, otherwise known as the Shed, that connects the Wallace Center with Monroe Hall. This 100,000 plus square foot facility was completed in 2023 and is now the focal point on campus. The building includes a large makerspace, space for project teams, a flexible performance theater, active classrooms, dance studios, and more. The Shed gets its name from the winning entrant in a student contest at the building held in spring 2021.
Across from the Wallace Center is the College of Liberal Arts. It is here where students gain both traditional liberal arts skills, like critical thinking and communication, along with technical skills. The College of Liberal Arts also sponsors musical, cultural, and artistic events. Next is the tallest building on campus, George Eastman Hall, named after the founder of Eastman Kodak. Eastman is home to both the administrative offices and the School of Individualized Study. The individualized degree is all about a student's ideas, interests, and goals. It is designed to help students be innovative and have a voice in their educational experience. We reached the Student Alumni Union, commonly referred to as the SAU. This union is the focal point of student life and diversity on campus. We see flags hung up on the upper walls signifying the 100 countries represented by students here at RIT. Others in the SAU represent 31 social fraternities and sororities. There are four cultural flags mounted in the SAU, serving as a visual marker of RIT's commitment to diversity, respect, equity, and inclusion. The Haudenosaunee flag, the Pride flag, the Black Lives Matter flag, and the Signed Union flag. Next, we arrive at the Hale Andrews Student Life Center. The center boasts 5 multi-purpose courts, 7 racquetball courts, and 1 squash court. Dance, aerobic, and Zumba classes take place in the Student Life Center as well. The facility includes a yoga room, weight room, elevated jogging track, and fitness lab with VR fitness training equipment. The Weidman Fitness Center, available to all full-time students, features a full range of machines, free weights, cardiovascular equipment, stretching area, and a CrossFit area. Our next stop is the Gordon Field House and Activity Center. The Gordon Fields House houses 3 indoor intramural playing fields adaptable for multiple sports activities, as well as a varsity use indoor track. The Field House provides a venue for commencements, concerts, and other special events, such as the Career Fair and Imagine RIT. Also located in the Field House is the Judson Aquatic Center, which contains an 8-lane competition-sized pool, a diving pool, a resistance lane, which most students use as a lazy river, and a 25-person hot tub. Farther down on the quarter mile, near the residential side of campus, is the Lyndon Baines Johnson Building, the home of the National Technical Institute for the Deaf. About 10% of RIT student population is deaf or hard of hearing and a part of NTID. NTID is the first and largest technological college in the world for deaf and hard of hearing students. Also in LBJ, you'll find the Dyer Art Center, home to the world's largest collection of art by professional deaf artists, as well as Robert F. Panera Theater, named for NTID's first deaf faculty member, who, by the way, was immortalized by the United States Postal Service on a stamp in 2017.
I am also pleased to show you RIT's updated athletic facilities. They include a new dedicated track and field facility that greets visitors entering campus from Jefferson Road. The baseball and softball fields have also received a significant upgrade that has extended the outdoor season for play and practice, and more accurately reflects the caliber of our softball and baseball programs. In addition, a newly constructed stadium will replace the existing structure, Tiger Stadium, taking our athletic facilities to the next level. The new stadium will include an upgraded turf playing field, permanent seating, locker rooms, and team rooms, as well as indoor and outdoor venues to host fans. The last stop on this tour is the Bosch and Lomb Center, home to admissions, financial aid and scholarships, and the Office of Career Services and Co-op Education. We would love to welcome you inside the Bosch and Lomb Center when you schedule an in-person campus visit. It's been my pleasure to show you the RIT campus.
Thank you for joining me, and go Tigers!